KARE in the Kitchen. We are happy to be back this week. We have a special guest chef, our executive producer on Sunrise, Jordy Foy.
Hello.
Jordy, so good to have you.
It's great to be here.
This is the moment you've been waiting for.
I've been talking a big game about my cooking skills, and they are putting me to the test.
Putting it to the test today.
So this is fun.
It is cold. We got snow in the forecast this week. Nothing says cold winter weather like a hot bowl of chili.
No.
Woo!
Wrong. Cheesy chicken enchilada soup. It was a last minute change.
Oh wait, sorry.
Because of the ingredients I had at my house.
Can we start over? It's too late. This is already live. We can't start. Sorry.
Last minute change.
That's right. You told me before.
It's just as good as chicken white chili.
That's right. Sorry. Soup.
And almost
soup
the same.
Soup is just as good. My bad. All right. So cheesy chicken enchilada soup.
Super easy to make. Mm. You've got, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 ingredients that you just put in this fine crock pot and voila,
let it cook
it's
up.
Done.
Okay.
So first things first, we want to cook the chicken.
So you already
it's pre-sliced.
Cut it up. So yeah. I should turn this on, huh?
Yeah, let's crank that up.
Crank it up. It does cook hot. Should I add some?
Chisel a little bit of oil.
Chisel
in
some
there.
Oil. Nice oil bottle here. If you comes out fast.
Get that heated
go.
Up. We're gonna turn the crock pot on too. I'm gonna turn this.
Oh, you should plug it in first.
I'm probably doing that. All right, we're gonna crank that to high.
Well, it's a good crock too.
Thank you.
It's been well used. The works, yeah. As all good crock pots are.
Yes. So we're gonna add 8 ounces of
green cheese.
Yep.
Oh my.
We're gonna add some enchilada sauce. I didn't have enchilada sauce, but I did have avocado salsa, which.
Avocado salsa?
Which will do just fine. So we're gonna do about, how many ounces is this? 16?
Just doing it all. That's what's fun with soups and chilies and whatever. Anything in a crock, you kind of just like throw it in and hope for the best.
The term cooking with soup is loose.
Yes.
So then we're gonna heat this
up. So far it looks really good.
Yeah, it's gonna be.
It's gonna be great.
Something.
It'll
be something. Then we're gonna add this.
What's this, chicken broth?
This is chicken broth. I've got my recipe written down.
That's okay.
/ printed off. We're gonna do about a cup of this.
So a cup?
About half of this.
Half of.
Yeah,
box.
32 ounces, 8 ounces of the cup.
Look at you. Good math.
That's about
good. This is getting hot over here. I can smell it.
It's hot. We're gonna crank this up, let that cheese get good and melty.
Okay.
And the recipe also calls for a can of beans.
Can of beans. Does it matter what kind of beans in this?
Black beans, I like
more,
to go
yeah,
with.
Yeah, it's like
more traditional.
The style, tradition, right? What you looking for? Oh, your tomatoes.
Diced tomatoes.
Diced,
a can of diced tomatoes, about 10 ounces of corn, and then a can of beans.
Easy.
Then you just plop it in.
Plop it in. Should we dump it here? Want me to dump this one in?
Yeah.
Nice. Whoop. So do you make there this you often, go. Or what made you want to do the soup?
Alicia, it's soup season.
Soup season, it's soup's easy.
There we go.
So bad.
And so yeah, I make soup once a week.
Do you really?
Yeah.
Good
and
for you.
Me and my wife, that is our meals for the week. Unless we want pizza, then we
right,
order pizza.
Right, then you order.
But.
Should I throw the chicken on? I feel like, I feel heat radiating. So I'm just gonna dump. So you just chopped up, what, 2 chicken breasts?
Yep. And then you season as you go.
Season as you go.
Oh, look at that sizzle.
Oh, yeah. Those are some big chicken chunks.
And there's an option. I like to shred.
Oh, do you? Okay.
The chicken. And that's why I brought these.
I need to get some of these. Bear claws.
Wolverine claws.
Oh, Wolverine. Yeah, well, that's cool.
Marvel.
Where'd you get these? Amazon?
My mom got them for me for Christmas.
Oh, that'd be a great gift.
Thanks,
Mom,
Debbie.
If you're watching. Thanks, Debbie. Shout out to Debbie. Should I put some, like you said, season as I go?
Season as you go. So I put a little chili powder in there, put a little salt.
Pepper.
And then while she does that, I'm going to cut up this pepper. Do you know the trick to cutting onions? I just learned.
You cut.
Actually, I think I already screwed
it up. I think you're supposed to cut it that way first. Right.
Yep.
You're supposed to leave the little nugget on, right?
Well, that works.
That's the worst. That's
the worst.
You still got it. I love how you brought your whole thing of salt. So you're not a salt shaker.
Thing. I was,
be careful I was, with this if you're seasoning.
I was dump procrastinating. So I come in.
Yeah, tell folks.
I come in around midnight, 12:30, and I was procrastinating all night. I was like, I'm going to get this ready. I'm going to get it all packaged up and ready to go so I can just walk out the door
right.
and go.
Yeah, people don't realize we got the you got the graveyard shift, essentially.
Yeah. And so I did not do that. I fell asleep watching a movie called Palm Springs. I'm into time travel
was it
movies
worth
right
it?
Now. Yeah,
was
totally
it
worth it.
Oh, okay.
But yeah, I woke up in a panic, chopped up the chicken, forgot some ingredients, and then just put everything in a carrier bag.
You know what, though? It's working for us. We still got the salt. We still got that spicy smell, the chili powder, black pepper, salt, pretty much any of your taco seasonings you're going to throw in.
And what's great about soup like this, because you're like frying up chicken and you've got stuff just kind of like melting and combined in the crock pot, it makes you feel like a really good cook. And when people enter your home, they're like, ooh
what that smells
smell. Good.
Better than the alternative. Oh, what is that smell?
And it's almost foolproof. Knock
on wood. Don't lose your pepper.
Yeah, so I'm going to cut this up. This
Look calls, at you chopping up your onion.
Yeah.
Don't cry.
Never. Do you know where I learned how to cut onions?
Gordon Ramsay?
No.
Your mom?
I loved it. Leave Debbie out of this.
No. Debbie?
I love to tell this story. I worked at a hot dog stand before working in the news.
Wow.
Yeah, I slung hot dogs.
Look at you.
So, Chicago dogs are my specialty. They require onions.
Onions, right. Okay, why aren't you making doggers on this episode of Care in the Kitchen then?
I didn't know that was an option.
It's always an option next time. Tune in next week.
There's a lot of skill to making hot dogs. You'd be surprised. You need the sesame bun.
Do you know
bun.
What's in the hot dog? You'll finally be able to tell us what it's made of.
I think we'll leave that out. Okay,
oh,
so there's
boy.
Half the onion.
It smells pretty good.
How's it looking over there?
It's cooking up. I'm not burning it, so that's the positive.
And while this melts, we should stir this a little bit as well.
Okay.
Maybe in the crock pot.
I don't want to burn things. I tend to do that.
Well, I screwed this one up.
It's all right.
It's all right.
Yeah, this is pretty easy. Chicken, throw it in the pot.
And usually crock pot soup you let sit. And like, you know, it's like 6 hours
stew.
To let. Yeah, stew, but
is this on
usually,
a high heat or what did
yeah,
you do?
I just
high
put
heat?
That on high heat. And because I'm cooking the chicken by itself, and then I'll saute
so
these vegetables.
With this paddle you brought. Cream cheese. See, I would have thought it was like a cream-based, like milk-based
oh, like
cream.
A heavy whipping cream?
Yes.
Yeah. Well, we're using the real stuff.
Going
put
all
this in.
In
a bowl here.
All right, gave it a stir.
Now, time for the...
So you don't put these in right away?
No, so we have to saute those.
Oh.
And so we'll wait till the chicken's done, and then, or close to done, and then light up that one.
Okay.
Light up that pan, put a little oil in it, and then once the onions get translucent, that's when you take them out and you can just combine everything.
Okay.
What's your go-to soup?
What is my go-to? I love a good French onion soup. Get it like a nice crusty baguette or kind of a day-old bread with a good cheese. You can do like Gruyere cheese. Or
I love a good crusty bread.
Oh my God, crusty bread and the soup. And then, yeah, make that up. I make mine with Guinness. I think I made it once for St. Patty's Day here in the kitchen. I'll have to bring that back. It was really tasty. Ooh. Real tasty. You smelling this?
I think maybe turn that down I'm no expert, but.
Neither of us are. People at home are just cringing.
Well,
it's
watching. Got a good color, though.
Oh, yeah.
So we're gonna get that in here.
You want me to get this pan, you said, with some onions going?
Yep, the onions are ready
right.
to be sauteed here.
Let's do this. Some olive oil.
And usually I like to go big with my soup. So even though the recipe calls for like
diced.
Yeah, one onion or two onions. Sometimes I put a little extra. I like that taste.
Yeah, get all the veggies in there. So this is getting hot. Look at
How's that going in there? What's this look like?
Good.
I could probably use a little stir. Yeah, so once this starts getting warm, then we kind of chop up this cream cheese in here and let it spread out.
Definitely smells good. This is getting warm. I'm gonna add my onions.
Get out these guys in a row.
You ever add jalapenos or other habaneros? Yeah.
But
kick it up a notch?
Because I've talked such a big game, I've had multiple people come up and say, you better save some for me. Cindy.
Uh-oh.
Our boss wants to eat it. So I don't know everyone's spice level. So
right.
I left the jalapeno out.
Minnesota, some people think ketchup is spicy.
Too spicy?
This is hot.
That's my parents.
Oh yeah, Jordy is from Wisconsin, so
we're
sorry.
Little spice I haven't called Ellsworth.
Ellsworth, cheese curd capital of the world. Also, fun fact about Jordy: tell the fine folks about your cheese curd eating competition.
Well, in Ellsworth, you're born to eat cheese. It's just in your blood. So they hold a cheese curd festival every June to celebrate our heritage. And the first year they did that, they had a cheese curd eating contest, which I took part in with a friend, and I won. I ate a pound of cheese curds in a minute and 14 seconds.
A pound of curds.
They stopped doing the competition and then picked it back up a couple years later.
Tell me why. Wait, do I want to know?
I scared so many people that they're like, oh my God, what is he doing? But they picked it up a couple years later, and the New York Times did a story on it.
Oh, wow.
And crowned somebody the record holder who ate, you know, some cheese curds in like 3 minutes. And
oh
so I emailed New York Times and I was like, do your research.
Credible, I am the record
yeah,
holder.
Yeah, credible reporting. but years later, I went on to meet my wife, Anna, who's from Forest Lake, and I found out her brothers were amateur competitive eaters. And they also have won the cheese curd eating contest in Ellsworth.
Oh my God.
And
it's meant to be.
Yeah, it's, let's just say Christmases get tense.
So you guys just have eating contests.
We try
Who can
not
eat
to.
This turkey?
But we finally decided to settle it at Sweeney's in St. Paul.
Yes, they're having the wings.
Yes, they're having a wing eating contest, which I won the year prior.
Wow.
And it was Bub. It was a classic competitive eater named Bub. Nate and myself.
Wow.
And I was crowned honorary champion because we ate them out of wings and they had to bring in more. I think the group size was about 32.
Jeez.
So we ate them out of wings, and when they brought up more wings, we kept eating. There's like a minute left and I ate so much that I ended up, you got sick. I got sick. And so they gave me honorary champion. They gave Bub first place and then Nate third place. So I like to say that that win was an asterisk on Bub.
Right.
Because I out-ate him, so.
Funny. Well, good for you. Good hobby to have.
It's not something that I want to do. Usually it's a pride thing.
Talked into.
Yeah. So how are those onions looking?
I just turned it up because it seemed like it was slacking. This chicken's looking good.
They're looking almost translucent. I think we can add this now.
Oh, yeah,
add those. Give it a little something there.
Throw it in.
Don't like to waste the butts of my green peppers, so I cut those up too.
Keeping the butts. Throwing that out. This looks fabulous, Jordy. It smells really good. This chicken.
You know what they say, if it smells good, it probably tastes good too.
That's true. That's true. This chicken might be done. It's like a steak. Do we want to bear or Wolverine this chicken? That's the new.
I think that's a safe bet.
You think?
Have you ever used these claws before?
No.
I say, give it a go.
It's pretty hot.
Do you want to scrape off this into the garbage? We'll do it onto the.
I thought you didn't waste.
Well, actually, I'm gonna take a little bite for myself.
Snack for the chef. There you go.
Okay. I'm gonna move this over.
Okay.
Because this could be a liability.
Liabilities.
This cord does not go very far.
No.
Maybe, I think, move this over here. Here we go.
There you go. We can turn
this down.
That's off. It's turned
off. And then
off.
Let's put the chicken right here.
This one's finally cooking up. This is sizzling fajitas over here. Watch yourself.
You know, I have a move called the sizzling bacon. A dance move.
A dance move? What's it look like?
I pull it out at weddings.
What's it look like?
So you fall backwards. Mm-hmm. You sizzle like you're in a pan.
It's kind of, you stole Weekend at Bernie's.
Yeah.
You sizzle. That's the Bernie dance,
well,
isn't it?
Well, you lay back and you go full sizzle.
Oh my gosh. We're losing all of our viewers. Oh, I'm making a mess. I need to get myself some of these claws.
Oh yeah, so now, I'll show you how it's done here.
This is a hot pan.
Then you really just shred.
Get after it.
No, it's
all
you
want me to do it? Oh my gosh, this is the hardest part of the operation. I feel like I need a bigger, is it done? Chicken, looks like. It'll cook in the crock pot. Oh, we almost lost one. I'm kind of shredding. Here we go.
You're natural.
It's easier if it's in bigger chunks, I think. Oh my goodness gracious. Look at this. These are just gonna be big, big chunks. Getting after it, folks. We're getting after it. Smells delightful.
Your Osceola accent really came out there. Getting her done.
Getting her done. Oh yeah, see my school played Ellsworth in our youth time.
Big rival.
You're in the same conference, right?
Yeah, the middle border. You're the
middle border.
You're the chieftains.
That's right, and you were the cheese curds, the Ellsworth cheese curds.
The milkman.
Is that what your mascot was?
No, but it should be.
It should be. What was your mascot?
The Panthers. Man,
that makes sense.
I've been really nailing it on nicknames lately. Alicia's hot dish.
My hot dish.
Yeah. The milkman. If you need a nickname, just let me know. Email me. Cheese boy.
Cheese
at
boy.
At AOL.
I'm struggling with this. Is anyone else sweating?
Do you want me to take over?
Yes. Yes, please. I'll stir the onions. Yeah.
So those could probably go in the pot too now. Yeah, give it a little stir and then throw those in.
Wow, stir in the pot. Jordy's always stirring the pot in the newsroom. All right, here we go. I should turn it off. Don't want to start anything on fire. Wow, look at this chicken chili. Get all the little nuggets.
And if it's too thick, if you like, you look in there and you're like, well, there's not a lot of liquid in there. Just add a little bit more chicken broth.
Oh, okay. Too thick or not thick enough?
You're right. This is a workout.
This is going to be money. It smells so good. I know, right? And that's going to add so much flavor. Would Gordon Ramsay approve of this or would he scream at us?
I've dabbled in some Top Chef, and that gives me so much anxiety when he's like, taste something, he's like, awful.
Throws it out.
Just leaves the plate without saying anything. That's
Look at this. Delightful.
There we go. Of all the things that I thought I'd be doing this week, this
is
not
one of them. Are you coming? Are you going to be a guest again someday?
I make a good pancake.
Oh, do you?
There's a few things that I have down. Like, I can pull out at any time if you give me the right ingredients.
You just get the box premix
and
add some water?
No. Homemade. a little bit of vanilla. And do you know what the secret is?
No.
I make them small, too. I make them little
tiny. So you can
tiny,
have a big stack.
So you can drizzle it with a little powdered sugar. And then sea salt. Put a little sea salt on the top.
Oh, salty cakes.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting. I never had a sea salt pancake.
It's a...
This your shredded is, chickens.
Well, if you ever... This is not as much fun as they look fun.
Right.
But actually, it's quite difficult.
It's easier than with a fork.
When you have a small surface like this...
I know. We're rookies. Do so much. This is rookie status.
Okay.
I was telling Jordy, we've had, like, world-renowned chefs on this show. And he's up there with them.
So being on here, I've learned that the KARE kitchen is not stocked very well.
No, it's not a real kitchen.
That's TV,
folks. It's all an illusion. It's TV, yeah.
That's TV, folks.
It's pretty much like we have an easy bake oven with a light bulb, and I'm just kidding.
Quickly microwaving things before we go on air. All right.
Do you think it's good? Should we just dump it in?
Let's do it.
Let it get cooking. Everyone's like watching. You know in SpongeBob when it's like 3 hours late, you're still shredding the chicken.
How long does an average KARE in the kitchen go for?
They're usually like 10 minutes. This one's special, though. It's a special. Look at that.
Oh, yeah, that's...
That's sick. Should we add more broth? Yeah, I mean, it's your soup.
You can add a little bit more broth in here.
This is super chili.
Well,
I'm kidding.
Who are we to define super chili?
Let's get into the philosophical deep questions. That looks good.
Okay, so we just kind of want to make sure that cream cheese is melted and stirred in.
And then it cooks for like a few hours on high or medium.
I mean, technically you could eat this now because all of it's cooked and sauteed and ready to go.
Well, maybe some of the chicken might have been questionable.
Yeah, maybe left this chicken sitting a little bit longer. And then I just give it...
Add
another
some more
little...
spice. Oh yeah, we'd add the chili flakes too. I like it hot.
Yeah. We're gonna add a little more chili in here. Because like I said, who are we to define enchilada soup or chili? Button this
you
up, give it a little
flakes. Yes.
Keep
going.
I'll give it another little.
Give it a yeah. Get after it.
Give it a little squirt of this.
If you want this recipe. Just throw stuff in.
There we go.
We'll share the recipe online, but I recommend watching the video to get the real recipe.
And then to finish it off, once it's all said and done, you add a little green pepper as toppings,
oh, yeah.
And then mozzarella. And voila.
Oh, top chicken. It off with a little cheese, yeah. maybe a little
tortillas.
Tortilla strips. Look at that.
Cheesy chicken enchilada soup.
Soup or chili, whatever you want to define
chili.
It as. Well, Chef Jordy Foy, thanks for the time. Thanks for being our fearless leader on Sunrise. We appreciate you. And we're all going to give this great reviews because you're the boss man.
Well, thank you.
All right. The recipe is posted at KARE11.com/recipes. Try it out. Let us know what you think or don't. Spare his feelings. And we'll be back next week with Thanksgiving stuff.
Wait, what are you making?
I don't know yet. To be determined.
Hey,
I'll come back. We're going to have a cheese curd eating contest. All right. Thanks for watching, everybody.